Soak it all in, folks. The final Winston Cup champion, well, in his final days of NASCAR. Here is Matt Kenseth's 2020 Credit One Bank Chevrolet Camaro. Howdy, howdy, folks. It's Diecast Buffet here again, and welcome back to a NASCAR Diecast review. And yes, it's a Matt Kenseth brand new 2020 Diecast. Yeah. This is going to be the last time ever, I would say, that we're going to get a Kenseth diecast from the current year that was raced in the current year. This is a 2020 diecast, so appreciate it while it lasts, folks, because you're witnessing one of NASCAR's greatest drivers of the 2000s in Matt Kenseth. I'm telling you, man, don't slouch on him. He is a first ballot Hall of Famer. I don't care what you say. This cat, sure, he is nowhere near as competitive as he was, but I tell you what, man. It took a lot of guts for this cat to come back and drive stock cars. And I tell you what, this is my God-honest opinion. If they didn't have the 2019 or 2020 rules package, Kenseth would be very good, in my opinion. I don't think he's going to be race-winning, maybe a one-off, but I don't think he likes the new rules package. And I think you could say the same thing for Jimmy Johnson as well. This is very similar to the Kyle Larson 2020 car, but there is a slight difference here and there. And without further ado, let's go and get this brand new Kenseth diecast out of the box. Here she is, folks, brand new out of the box, and this very well could be the final Matt Kenseth diecast ever made. His McDonald's car got DMP'd. I don't know if they're gonna make the Clover one, but I tell you what, man, whenever they made the announcement that Kenseth was gonna drive the 42 car, I got all giddy inside. I was like, Matt Kenseth is back in NASCAR? I thought it was a slam dunk that Chastain was going to take over the 42. He takes it over in 2021. Matt Kenseth made the jump from retirement, traveling across the world, back into a stock car in the Premier Series in North America. And it was so cool, right? Crazy year, crazy situation. There was rumors that Jamie McMurray was going to get in this car. Even Carl Edwards... Chip Ganassi Racing contacted Carl Edwards, and they said, hey, bud, you want to drive the 42 car? I know, there's many Edwards fans like myself. Could you imagine if Carl Edwards jumped into the 42 car? There is not a doubt in my mind that the 42 would have made the playoffs, and it would have made the playoffs easily, in my opinion. Because Carl Edwards, I'm telling you, man, I think it's kind of interesting. Carl Edwards, to me, is a natural talent. To me, he is a natural talent. He's not one of these drivers that are just, they get into it with money and then they get into the sport. No. To me, Carl Edwards is a wheel man, right? He reminds me of Jimmy Johnson. Jimmy Johnson's a wheel man. He's a natural talent driver. That's why he's so successful. Jeff Gordon, Tony Stewart, natural talents. Kyle Larson as well is a natural talent, in my opinion. And I tell you what, man, it was so cool to hear that Carl Edwards is even considered for the job. Even Jerry McMurray, I believe, was considered as well. But they settled on Kenseth, and I think that was a great choice by him. Now, I will say, his first race was really good when he came back, that Sunday Donington return, you know, because during those weeks before the season got restarted, there was so much hype about the Donington race. But then the thing about it, Kenseth is returning, Ryan Newman was returning. It was like it was so cool because you had Newman returning, Kenseth returning. They're going to a daytime 400-mile Darlington race. It was so cool. Got Credit One Bank there. Go get to the nose of the car. And the paint scheme, like I said, it's so similar to the 2020 Larson paint scheme. But there are some slight differences. Obviously, the white at the bottom of the car is now black. But to tell you the truth, it actually looks pretty good with that. Because it goes well with the outlining on the 42. It goes well with the interior and also with the wheels as well. Not to mention the spoiler. Very, very sharp. So you got the Chip Ganassi Racing logo there. Got Lincoln Welders, 3M, Sunoco, Chevrolet bow tie right there, ZL1, 42. We go over to the left side of this diecast. And this is so cool, man, because, you know, I really didn't think they were going to make a Kenseth diecast. I was kind of on the fence about it, you know. He only raced, you know, I mean, he raced 32 out of 36 races, pretty much, right? Who knows if, you know, they were going to produce it or not. But sure enough, they did. And I was so happy they did. I was really happy they finally produced the Kenseth diecast. And I there's a chance we're going to get one more. You never know. But one thing everyone forgets, I mean, everyone forgets, Kenseth nearly won the 2020 Brickyard 400. Think about it. Go back to it. Harvick, yeah, won the race. Hamlin, he did the Watusi into the fence, but Kenseth had a legitimate shot to win the Brickyard 400 in his final NASCAR career year. I mean, what? And what was even more special is that, in my opinion, was the final Brickyard 400. Because the Brickyard at the road course, it's a entirely different event. It's like the Roval. It's an entirely different event. Will they ever bring back the Brickyard? Who knows? But Kenseth almost won the final one as of right now. So we got, I don't think that's Haas there. I don't know what the heck that is. Maybe Cessna, Clover, and maybe Freightliner. Got Credit One. You got McDonald's, Simeons, Sherwin Williams, Lincoln Welders, and something there. Got the Goodyear right there. I like the outlining on that. NASCAR Cup Series. And the paint scheme is very moderate, right? It's like a slight tribal kind of wave with a little bit of some fading, some bright blue and dark blue patterns going on. Very sharp, though. Very sharp, very simple. But I think it looks very good, honestly. And, of course, you go over here to the caboose of this diecast. We'll zoom in a little bit here, and you can see how the back end of the car is also very, I'll be honest with you, very similar as well. This is a really cool touch in the paint scheme as well. So, obviously, Credit One Bank is the primary sponsor, but they also included the Credit One card. I think that's pretty cool right there. Got the little credit card right there. Got the 42 Camaro ZL1 1LE. Got the Chevrolet bow tie with the spoiler, the Chevrolet Camaro Cup car. And I tell you what, it's so cool to think that Matt Kenseth drove a Chevrolet in the Cup Series. You know, this guy back in the 2000s, for the younger cats out there, he was pretty much Mr. Ford, right? He was, everyone and their mother looked at Matt Kenseth and they said, that's a Ford guy, right? They look like Jeff Gordon, that's a Chevy guy. Earnhardt, a Chevy guy. Johnson, a Chevy guy. Kenseth was a Ford guy. And when he made the hopscotch from Roush to Toyota, it rubbed a lot of people the wrong way. And to think that this cat's going to end his career in a bow tie, that is so freaking cool, man. That is just so cool. As a Chevy cat myself, I've always wanted Kenseth to drive a Chevrolet. And I tell you what, it was really cool. So you go over to the right side of the car. The decal job, honestly, is actually very good on here, but there's just a slight few oopsies, like this little wave right here, this random scratch or something there. And I think I seen something over here as well. Yeah, the T right there is kind of cut off right at the bottom. But yeah, it's fixed on this side. So there's a few little decal issues. Obviously, check out the Matt Kenseth signature. That's something, that's retro, man. That's retro to see a signature on one of these doors nowadays. Go over to the roof of the car. Of course, you got the 42. Got Credit One Bank. And of course, you got the Kenseth name banner on the back windshield. And nothing on the deck lid. And you know, when I went to Texas Motor Speedway, I got to see three cats that I personally grew up watching: Clint Bowyer, Jimmy Johnson, and Matt Kenseth. And I got to witness their final full-time seasons. I got to see them one final time. Granted, it was for 52 laps. 52 laps. But that's Mother Nature for you, right? Because the three-day rain, the Sierra Mist 500 presented by the Weather Channel came through Fort Worth. It was insane. But to see Matt Kenseth race for the first time, because I didn't get to see him in 2019, right? Because he wasn't racing. If it went in 2018, maybe I could have seen him. But I got to see Kenseth race. I got to see Bowyer and Jimmy. It was so cool. Do I think one of them's going to make one more start in their career? I think Kenseth's done. I think Bowyer could. I would not be surprised if Bowyer showed up at the Southern 500 or something. You know, just say, hey, I want to go race Kansas. And he gets a one race deal after the Fox portion of the schedule is done. I could see him doing that. Johnson, I think he's going to be running IndyCar. Something tells me Johnson's going to make one more start. Because with fans and everything, I think Johnson's going to make one more start in NASCAR. I don't know where. It could be the IMS road course. Who freaking knows? Anyways, folks, thank you all so much for watching the video. Make sure to give it a big thumbs up, like, comment, and subscribe. Hope to see you on the next video. Tell me what y'all think about this 2020 Matt Kenseth Credit One Bank Chevrolet Camaro. I tell you what, though. If you can get this car, absolutely recommend it. It's a really cool paint scheme, and the Larson one is very cheap right now. That's another good one you could pick up. It's like roughly around $6 or $7 from what I've seen. It's definitely went down in value, but this one could go up, as this might just be Matt Kenseth's final diecast ever. Anyways, folks, have a great one. Stay humble. Diecast Buffet, signing off, Mike. My-